chosen ones. Together, we're gonna break this illusion. Yeah, I'm gonna paint a picture for you, and you need to break it down within your own life and look at what I'm talking about and apply it to your own life. Yeah, because a lot of us fall victim to believing that the narcissist has run off to the new supply and it's all sunshine and rainbows, happily ever after. You might have caught a glimpse of them on social media, smiling, you know. You've seen them smiling, maybe holding hands, you know. This photo that you've seen, and it scarred your mind a little, yeah? It's not all sunshine and rainbows, believe you me, yeah? Remember, they've downgraded. It doesn't matter if this person looks like, however, it's not all about looks. They've downgraded because they couldn't handle you. That's the first thing why they downgrade. They couldn't handle you. That's why they done what they done, to try and gain control of you. Whether they discarded you, forced you to leave, pushed you so far to breaking point or whatever, yeah? But they downgrade, and then they treat the new supply worse than they ever treated you. They become a lot more toxic with time. Narcissists get worse with age. So if you was with them a year ago, believe you me, a year later, they're a lot worse. Let's keep it simple. So if you was with them 3 years ago, then they're a lot worse now. Yeah, just with time, they're getting worse. And they're treating the new supply like trash. Yeah? They're treating the new supply like trash. Even if they've ran into a new supply that's a narcissist, then they're treating him like trash even more. And they blame the new supply for losing you. Please press the like and the subscribe button. Help your brother out. It'll take 2 seconds of your time. The reason why they blame the new supply for losing you, right? You become the golden X. No matter what, you become the golden X in the mind of the narcissist. No matter how much they've smeared your name and presented it to the people. They may not outwardly speak it to people. Maybe their dearest and closest, they might tell the inner truth about they're really missing you. Yeah, but they keep it hidden. But they blame this narcissist. They blame the new supply, sorry. They blame the new supply for losing you, because they were probably lining up the new supply when they was with you. Yeah, a lot of them do that. Yeah, they reach out and they go for their new supply when they're with you, because they was in a delusion where they thought that the grass was greener. Yeah, so when they got over there, you know, at first they thought, right, I know I've hurt them so much, they're going to be looking at my social media, talking about you, they're thinking, right? They're thinking, yeah, they're going to be looking at my social media. Let me paint a picture for them. Let me display that I'm so happy and I'm so past them. Let me try and hurt them some more. So they post that picture, and you know, like us, like idiots, we'd always do it, don't we? We have to blame ourselves. We have a look at their social media. We've all done it, and you know, we have to stop doing it, but we have done it, and we've seen something we shouldn't have seen, and it took us by surprise. But what you saw there was not reality. You do not see them when they go loggerheads behind closed doors. You do not see them when, if for example, this person is a narcissist that they've run into, or another toxic individual, psychopath, sociopath, they're all toxic, yeah? If they run into another toxic individual, it's going to be very, very dry there. Like, both of them don't know how to create energy. They don't have their own energy. They don't have their own light, so they're stuck together. They might be able to appear smiley for the camera show. They might be able to do that all the way. But really deep down beneath the surface, they're not happy. It's all a facade. Okay, let's paint another picture. Let's say that they ran into a new supply who's a decent supply. They're a good person and all that. They're not going to recognize someone good encountering their lives because they're so caught up on the past. Let's look at it from a human level now. Let's look at it from a human level. Naturally, if you've broken up with someone, yeah, unless you're a psychopath or something, but if we've broken up with someone, then naturally we need a bit of healing time. If we rush into another relationship, you call it a rebound, yeah? That's what we call it, yeah? Like, oh, it's a rebound. These lot rebound all over the place, all over the park, you know what I'm saying? They rebound all over the place. This is what they do, yeah? These narcissists, okay? So they treat this new supply like trash, yeah? And the new supply is not knowing what's hit them. You know what I'm saying? They don't know what's hit them. Because if they was lining up new supply when you were still around, you know, the narcissist, your ex-narcissist, was painting a picture to them like they're whatever. When they get into each other's company, they're miserable, yeah? They're miserable. Proper miserable. And this is why you have to look behind the veil to see what the true picture really is that I'm trying to paint to you, yeah? The narcissist downgraded and left you because they can't handle you. You're too pure for them. You're unbreakable. You're resilient. You showed strength. However much they ground you down, you showed strength and determination. So they decided to finish you off, and they wanted to go and run away to someone new, rub it in your face, and they thought that you would be there to take them back with arms open. That's what they thought you will be like. But we're not going to be like that. They thought that they could run away to someone else, sleep with them, be intimate with them, post pictures on social media, smear it in our face, and they thought that we'd let them back in our lives. Yeah? They thought that they could break us down to the point of no return when we welcome them back in their lives, because we've seen their life and their sunshine and rainbows without us. Or they thought we was going to continuously reach out to them and contact them and say, why have you done this to me? Why have you hurt me? Why have you moved on so fast? Oh no. Oh, they never loved me. They wanted to hurt you, yeah? But when they got over to this new supply, believe you me, man, all they can do is think about you. But you know why they only can think about you? Because you're an empath. Because they know you're awakened now. They know you're chosen. In the spiritual realm, they're devils, they're entities. They know about you, yeah? So they'll come in the mind of the narcissist. They torment the narcissist as well. If we act like these lot are plagued with devils, but they don't torment the narcissist. Remember, the devils are not subservient realistically to mankind. They're not fully subservient to mankind. The devil doesn't like mankind. So these devils around them, whether they're lower down devils, not the big devil, but these lower down entities and all of that stuff, they cause turmoil in the life of the narcissist. They plague the narcissist with regret and miscalculation of their decisions. You know, the narcissist is very destructive. That's why everything that they touch crumbles, turns to dust. That's why the relationship between yourselves turned to dust, yeah? That's why it done it, because everything they touch, they bring devastation to. And within their own minds, they bring devastation within their own minds. So just know that the narcissist has downgraded, yeah? And they're treating that new supply a lot worse than they ever treated you. And the reason why they're treating that new supply a lot worse than they ever treated you is because they want you. They may not say it. They may not tell you. But the more pictures you see of them all happily ever after on their social media, is the more they want you back. And then if you don't retaliate, like in my situation, I didn't retaliate with the social media. I kind of went ghost on the social media. Totally. Like, I didn't really use it anyway, even when I was with the narcissist. But I totally went ghost, yeah? Didn't feed them nothing, yeah? And then I did, like an idiot, sometime after, I did have a look back on their social media, and they privatized it all, so I couldn't see anything. So they tried to play my card that I'm doing, where I don't let them see what I'm doing. I don't let them know what I'm doing, my whereabouts. I don't let them know nothing through that stuff. And on one side, you know, I done it for a period of time to heal, you know. I didn't have any business to do with my social media or anything like that. So it wasn't stopping business. It was only like personal social media. It wasn't like I had anything making money off it or doing something like business related through social media, selling products or something like that, which would have caused a devastation if I did lock off my social media. So it wasn't that much of a consequence. Like, but it's taken me some time. That's why I've got into the YouTube thing now. But I've took some time to heal through my journey and fully understand it. And the more I've understood it, the more I've traced it back, the more that I've seen that I've had them through my life from before I realized. It was the romantic partner that made me realize and have the eureka moment about the narcissist. But then I've traced it back to my start. I made a video about it earlier, few days ago or something. And I mentioned that there was a man that moved to my area and stuff like that. And he was a narcissist, and he kind of influenced all the young kids around there through, because it's a not a poverty-stricken area, but it's not exactly a rich area, and he kind of manipulated us through drugs and things like that. And he was a narcissist or a psychopath, had a friend, so-called friend, that was a psychopath or a narcissist. So I've seen them about, and also the narcissist, the romantic partner was a narcissist. So, and I've encountered many more that I haven't got too deeply intertangled with. But what I'm trying to say to you is, yeah, is this narcissist has moved forward very rashly and very quickly in their lives. And they, whatever they touch, it turns to dust anyway, yeah? So, I don't know, like, we can't think that these lot are over there in this place with this new supply. It's sunshine and rainbows. They're the best couple ever, you know? They're the best couple ever in the world. This is what they're trying to paint to you. That's what they're trying to paint. They're trying to show that to you. Do you know what I'm saying? They're trying to... But they've downgraded. They have downgraded. You know what I'm saying? We don't know that... Like, probably if you had a conversation with a new supplier, you'll say, oh God, now I know why they picked them. Now I know why they picked them. God, I was definitely too much for them. I caused them trouble. You know what I'm saying? This new supply might be a proper sucker. This new supply might be a narcissist. This new supply, but either way, they've downgraded after you. If you was in a relationship with them, you created a bond with them and all of that, they miss that bond. They miss it. They miss that bond. They miss the way that you used to say things. They miss the way that you used to be intimate with them in the bedroom. They miss the things that they miss the way that maybe you used to cook a certain dish. Yeah? They miss these things. Because all this was supply for them, and they miss that potent supply, yeah? So because they miss this potent supply that you are, they treat them like trash. The narcissist is upset about you and caught up on you and misses your connection, you know? The new supply might ask them one day, what's wrong with you? What's wrong with you? You know what I mean? And the narcissist can't tell them. They can't tell them. They won't tell them. And plus, they've already told them that you were the worst thing that ever encountered their lives. They've already told them that you were the worst thing ever. That you were toxic. That you were this, that you were that. They're always the victim. They're always the victim. They love being the victim. They're the oppressor and the victim, all wrapped in one. Yeah, they're not really the victim, but they act like the victim. They oppress people, and this is what they do. But they can't tell the new supplier that the reason that they're acting this way is because they miss you. They're never going to tell you that. They might tell their best friend or their close friend or something like that. They may tell them, or a close family member. They may tell them, you know what I'm saying? Someone who's like one of their flying monkeys, someone... Do you know what I'm saying? One of their nearest and dearest, they might tell them. They might tell them to get advice on how to deal with it. But everything that I'm telling you, yeah, I don't want you to use this to go back with them. You know what I'm saying? Everything I'm saying, yeah, take what you can from it and disregard the rest. If something you don't agree with what I said, remember, I'm only making these videos broadly. I don't know your personal ins and outs. But all I know, on a basic level, yeah, a fundamental understanding that we all should share, is that if we've encountered a narcissist, we've encountered these devils, and we've encountered this dark side, we all can raise the bar and do better than that. All of us collectively, empaths, can all do better than getting with a narcissist. Do you know what I'm saying? And if you choose to go back to the narcissist with this information, they're only going to get worse too. Do you know what I'm saying? But they are caught up on you. They do miss you. And this is when they finally reciprocate what you've done. They finally reciprocate what you've done from them. Yeah? And now with their suffering, you begin to reap your fruits. Yeah? You reap your fruits. All of your labor, you're reaping your fruits because they're suffering now. And I want to break that illusion. That's what I meant earlier on about painting a picture for you. I want to break that illusion that these lot have run off into the sunset happily ever after with a new supply. They're holding hands. It's romantic. You know, it's beautiful. Like, throw that out the window. Throw that out the window. That is not what's happening. It's just definitely not. Trust me, it's not. Yeah, and you lot now, you lot need to look into your own life. If you're thinking about it, do not have to think about it, but if you're thinking about it later on or something, think into it and look for the signs. You have to look beneath the veil. There's a lot of signs that they show. They're not as slick and covert as you think they are. Yeah, they slip up along the way, and there's a lot of red flags. There's a lot of things that they've done wrong, and there's a lot of slip-ups to prove is what I'm saying is factual. Yeah, there's a lot of things that they do. Like I've said earlier on about the social media, never give into that illusion. Social media is a big illusion anyway, but these lot just utilize it to be the biggest illusion ever, and they paint it like they're the happiest thing ever. They paint themselves like it, you know what I'm saying, because they're all on the surface, but they can never get down to the core of it about what they're really truly feeling, you know what I'm saying. So just know they're downgraded, they monkey branched for some low hanging fruit, some dusty low hanging fruit. It's a rebound. They rebounded into this thing, and they tried to glorify it to you like it's the best thing ever. And then they get the realization. When they get the realization, it hits them hard. That's why I said that narcissist went ghost. After I went ghost, the narcissist went ghost on their social media. Because they've got rid of that new supply that they were just presenting on it, and they're trying to jump to another one. Do you know what I'm saying? That's what it's really about. Or sometimes they just settle with these new suppliers. They will just settle with these new suppliers because they know they can't be at your... They're not at your level. They're not at your level. They can't raise the bar beyond you again. They can't do it. They can't raise the bar like to your level. They can't do it. So they have to settle for something less. They have to settle for something less. They're getting older. They're getting less slick. You know what I'm saying? They couldn't break you. They dragged you through the mud. They couldn't break you down fully. So, and you lot are going to heal from your trauma bonds. That's what this whole thing is. The only reason that we caught up on them is through the trauma bond, the demonic soul tie. That's the only reason that we end up being caught off of them, caught up on them for a long period of time afterwards, is the trauma bond. Once you break the trauma bond, and this is what I want you to do looking forward, if you're still caught up on them, yeah? You've got to say to yourself, this person is a liar. This person deceived me. This person is a narcissist. Okay? I can do better than that. I can do better. And I would rather be on my own, alone, than with that. And that's where I'm at. I would a million times rather be on my own. I enjoy my own company. I enjoy my own company. I don't have time to let that drama back in my life. And I don't have any time to let any drama like that in my life from another individual ever again in my life. I just don't have it. You know what I'm saying? I made my mistake and I've learned from it. And there was a blessing from it, because now moving forward, I'm not taking none of that crap from no one. I'm not going to take none of that crap from anybody moving forward. Once I see a glimmer of this narc behavior, once I see a glimmer of this in someone else, it's going to make me close off and look for the door and get out of the situation. And I've been in it afterwards, and I've encountered individuals afterwards, and it was quite soon afterwards. I didn't get too involved with them, but looking back now, there was obvious signs that they were narcissists or some kind of toxic personality. You know, there was one that said her dad owned a black magic shop, and then I was still healing from the narcissist, so I kind of just overlooked it. But like, who owns a black magic shop? It's just weird. It's just weird. It's just a bunch of weirdos. Do you know what I mean? They're in touch with these devils. They're in touch with these devils. Do you know what I mean? So just know that the narcissist has downgraded. I've gone on a bit long now. I've probably gone off topic a bit. But I'm just saying, the narcissist has downgraded. Yeah? And they're treating this new supplier a lot worse than they ever treated you. Yeah? Whether the narcissist, whether the new supplier is good, whether the new supplier is a narcissist, whether the new supplier is a psychopath, a sociopath, or whether the narcissist is just a, or the new supplier is a decent person. Even if the new supplier is a decent person, they're going to treat them like trash because they miss you. They think they're so clever creating these trauma bonds. They think they're so slick with it. Yeah? Love bombing, hot and cold, devaluation. They think they're so slick with all of their movements, yeah? But these that are bonded to you, remember that. It's a two-way street. If you're intimate with someone, there's energy, there's a transfer of energy. There's things in the spiritual realm that attract you to. There's a bond that you two create. They can't just masquerade through life with artificial light and think it don't catch up with them. It catches up with them. So just don't give in to the illusion, whatever you saw, and try to forget about that picture that you saw on their social media or stuff like that. Trust me, these lot don't know what they're doing, yeah? And they're caught up on you. And you're that one person now in their life. If you shut the door and door slam them and you don't let them back in, yeah? And that's the one person they can never have in their life. You know what I mean? And that's, so as much as they've hurt us and done this and that, by us thinking smart, standing our ground, saying no more, we're that one person that escaped their toxic thing. So if the new supplier lives with them to old age, best of luck to them. Do you know what I'm saying? Best of luck to them, man. Because it's just a disaster. Do you know what I mean? And if it does last to our old age, the new supplier is probably just as much of a weirdo as the narcissist. Probably just as much of a weirdo. That's what you got to think about. So they both can be there with their little weird behaviours and their weird stuff, and they can do whatever they want. Do you know what I'm saying? We don't need to be jealous of that. Like, we have a light. We have an essence. These lot have no light. Yeah? And I'm sure of it. Most likely they've run into a toxic individual. This day and age is plagued with them. It's plagued with toxic individuals from all corners. It's just plagued for them. That's why I don't mind that my, like, when I talk about chosen ones or empaths or things like this, a lot of people don't even resonate with this subject that we're understanding and talking about, or you're listening to, and you're leaving your comments, and we're reasoning with one another. A lot of people don't even understand this. And the reason why we understand it is because we've been through the pain. We've been through the hurt. And they're going through the pain and the hurt now with their downgrade supply. And they're treating them like trash. Trust me. So anyway, I've gone on a little long, but I'll leave the video there. And please press the like and the subscribe button. And if you want a one-to-one session, you can find the details in the description box. Anyway, I'll catch you all soon. Peace.